time to get up.
I am up.
Just a minute, it's already small.
Declan! We're in our telebed. Telebed? Where's the script?
Over there.
Oh, no. We're for it now.
Gentlemen, your flight of fancy is about to depart. Your man in the cockpit, Declan Jumbo Jet Donnelly. Your baggage handler, Anthony Microlight McPartlin.
Yes, I'm Declan. He's a mess man.
Well, I'm Anthony, and he's a tragedy.
Well, I am Donnelly, and you're an apology.
Well, I'm McPartlin, and you're always farting. Well, I'm the tissue one. You've got the fishy gums.
But I'm the important one, and you've got a little one.
Well, I'm the funny one, and you've got a dirty, runny bum.
Before we go on, we must make an apology. You must forgive our ragged demeanours, but last night, we spent last night in the lap of debauchery.
Was that the French lap?
No, no. It was at that showbiz type bash.
All right, I see.
At you.
What's that?
Oh, it's just a little bit of a call I've got coming on.
Since when?
Oh, please, Ollie, I'm sure the audience do want to know how I danced naked on Ronnie Corbett's party. With a mystery hooded celebrity.
Eh?
Mad Magenta and Sexy Dixie in Nudie Nightmare.
Oh dear. Not more front page headlines, is it?
Dumb Divine swears revenge on Pudgy Popstar.
Just get on with the show.
Well, I don't know me lines. Anybody know what's happening next? Anyone?
Oh, I know, sir. Listen. You pick on an unsuspecting someone, sir.
Ah, well done, Dudley.
Thank you.
Have a star. Well, you did last night, didn't you, mate? Oh, okay, sorry. How about you, young fella down here? Come here.
Yeah,
how about him?
Hey, look, yeah, he
is
looks
he all right?
Looks good.
Yeah?
What did he do to vexate you so, Ant?
He looked at his funny deck.
Oh,
ah, that's it, Ant.
Heinous. Heinous.
They're clearing up, though, Deck.
Is it clean?
Yeah.
Well, and what's his punishment, then, Ant?
Prompt, that's it. You can be the prompt for tonight's show. If you'd like to follow me up here, sit there, and when we forget our words and stuff, just look at this poop and help us out. All right, mate.
All right.
Eh?
Top.
Draylen, what do we do now, then, eh?
Oh, the usual. I'll have a TV show idea. You'll ruin it. I'll come off for the lass you fancy. You'll seek revenge. I'll be wise to it. You'll look like a fool. The lass will take pity on you. I'll get food. We'll do a song, and that'll be the end.
Can't we just muck about?
Just muck about. Just muck about. Aye, okay.
Yes. Alien abduction is a widely reported phenomenon. So widely reported that it's about as interesting as an ingrown bum hair. Yet, Eddie here knows only too well how real alien abduction can be. Eddie, how old were you when you abducted your first alien?
I was 18.
So when people of your age went to music and parties, you...
I was abducting alien life forms, yes. And I started small with just sort of Martians and Venusians. And then I built up to Daleks and, like that one there. And Cybermen with the big tubes that come out of the ears. And then I got a Wookiee once and that big hairy monster and shoved him in a bag and kept him in a bedroom. And did you tell anybody about your alien abductions?
Well, my mum noticed because she noticed R2-D2 under my bed with the Wookiee, and it all got a bit weird at that point.
Bit of a lunatic, aren't you, Eddie?
Yeah, just a bit.
I'm going to ignore you now. Please don't bother me again, okay?
Sorry.
Well, viewers, is that spooky?
I got Dr. Spock in a cupboard.
Or what?
This week for Love 'Em and Leave 'Em Donnelly. Beat that, Maguire.
This time, your philandering will be your downfall, Donnelly.
Oh, right. What's next, then?
I don't know.
What? Open this here scary door, which we never usually open or never usually see, which must have some significant bearing on this week's plot.
I don't know.
Are you sure?
I don't know.
Okay, don't shout, I'm going. Okay. God, blind. Maybe I should take some protection. Well, it works for me. Dummy knob, which must mean there's a real knob round here somewhere. Damn it! The scary door. I never did anything, sir. Sir, it wasn't me. It was him, sir.
You should never open the scary door.
Why?
Why? I'll tell you. Many moons ago, this studio played host to the glittering stars of British light entertainment. Names like Duncan Norvell, Bobby Ball and Bob Carroll G's performed top-hit shows like Runaround, Bobby Davros Laughing and Magpie. But when their careers ended, their showbiz spirits left their bodies and took refuge in the underground dressing rooms behind that door. Open it and their spirits will possess you!
I don't believe.
Well, it doesn't budge anyway. Perhaps if I had a handy axe nearby that I could hack my way through it with. Bless
Declan.
Oh, cheers.
Insides!
Do you not?
Mr. Swartz!
God.
Me! Oh, Mr. Fishmonger! I think this curse sticks so badly for my collection! Oh, please!
Oh, it's Mr. Swartz. Hello, Mr. Swartz. What do you have to swap, then?
Let me see what I've got in my big swapping pocket.
What? No, not one of those. Too. I have all the fish collection right here under my nose, Mr. Swartz.
I need those to go with me fish chips.
Fish. Go on, surprise yourself.
Oh, great swap, eh? And those chips didn't have any salt and vinegar on them. Cod, scampi, panic, squid. God.
Quick plot update, everyone. Declan has been possessed by the spirit of late LA star Frankie Howard. And for the rest of the show, well, we've been just mucking about, really.
I don't want to be blunt, but you're not Morecambe and Wise, are you? I mean, they were really professional.
Oh, look, I'm all right, and... No! It's only Miles.
Silence! Your meagre frame cannot sustain that much talent. But with my mad capsized ideas, I will exorcise you.
How's aerobics going to help me at a time like this? Oh, poor woman. Oh, nervous. Stop that. Oh, no. Lay there. Fast there. Oh, and you've got to do something.
Okay. Let me think.
The simpleton is thinking. That means I'll have hours to do away with Donnelly. And this time, I will not fail.
Oh, that was close.
Rats!
I've got it!
And in record time.
Nah, I don't know, I was just mucking about.
Stars and all for nothing.
Hey, do you know why we've got these stupid uniforms on?
No, but you see it, and I'll have it.
It's probably for some sketch with some quiz show host stroke, musical performer stroke, all-round entertainer.
Aye, I suppose.
Somebody like Andrew O'Connor? It's Andrew O'Connor!
I'm here to the airport sketch.
Airport sketch, Dick.
Airport sketch, Andrew.
Declan.
Anthony.
Declan Donnelly.
Anthony McParlin.
I'll do your middle name.
You will not.
You did know I was coming, right?
No, Mrs. No.
Shut up, Frankie.
Is there something wrong with his voice?
He's heard the records, then.
Shouldn't we? Everyone's a music critic, really.
No, he's fine. He's all right.
So, shall we do the sketch?
Yes. Yes, certainly. Of course we will. It's just that...
Well, we cannot, Mr. O'Connor, sir, because, Dick?
because we've got a commercial break.
Good one, Declan Jemima Donnelly.
Enjoy the break, Donnelly. It'll be the last one you ever see.
Will the gruesome twosome learn their lines? Will the hooded beauty blow Deck up? Will Ma open this door? Tune in and find out after the break.